Want a pizza desk of your very own? Stick around and I'll show you how to make one. I'm starting off with a 4 foot by 4 foot section of 3/4 inch plywood, and I'm making a mark from corner to corner. After lining up my track saw guide to the line, I cut the sheet of plywood in half. In order to ensure that I end up with matching sides, I measure out one side and transfer the measurement to the other side. I want the crust end of the table to have a nice curve, and in order to do that, I start by driving a nail into the corner and to the mark I just made. Using a thin, flexible piece of wood braced against the two nails, I pull it to the curve that I want. I drive in another nail into the mark I just made, and this will be used to hold the piece of wood into the curve that I want. This method allows me to get a smooth, consistent curve across the entire piece. The nails are no longer needed, so I remove them. Using my jigsaw, I cut on the line as accurately as possible. I was very excited to see that the laminate blade I used in my jigsaw left almost no tear on the faces of the plywood. Using 60 grit sandpaper, I smooth out any unevenness left behind by the jigsaw. Here's what the top looks like after everything's been cut to size. Next up, I measure out to 40.5 inches, which is where I want the cheese to end and the crust to start. Using another 4 foot by 4 foot sheet of 3/4 inch plywood, I'll make the cheese that's dripping off the side of the table. I start by making a mark at 12 inches. Using my track saw, I cut the piece to width. I cut two pieces out to the exact same size. Using a level as a straight edge, I square up both pieces. I then make a mark at 40.5 inches long. I then cut the pieces out to final length. With the pieces cut out, I freehand an ooey gooey melty cheese design. With the design sketched out, I cut them to shape using my jigsaw and a scroll cut blade. The super thin scroll cut blade allowed me to navigate the twists and turns easily. With both side pieces cut out, we can attach them to the top. But there's a bit of a problem. The squared ends won't fit on the pointed tip. In order to fix that, I trimmed the ends at a diagonal on my bandsaw. With the ends trimmed, I moved on to drilling pocket holes into the side pieces, which is how I'll be attaching them to the top. This is actually my first time using pocket holes, and I gotta say, I'm a big fan. With the pocket holes drilled, I applied Type-On Original wood glue and spread it out with the glue brush. I clamped the side piece securely to the top, and then I drove in the pocket screws. After letting the glue dry overnight, I could then remove the clamps. I played it pretty fast and loose with the bandsaw when trimming the sides, and I ended up with a pretty big gap. To fix this, I cut a wedge out of some scrap plywood and glued it in place. After letting the glue dry, I cut the piece to size using my Japanese flush cut saw. With a bit of quick sanding and some filing, it's looking a whole lot better. The plywood I used wasn't exactly the highest quality, and when the pieces were cut to size, it revealed some voids along the edges. Using wood filler, I filled them all in. While waiting on the wood glue and wood filler to dry, I can work on the table legs. And they were inspired by these plastic pizza savers you get on top of your pizza. To mimic the look of the plastic pizza savers, I'll be using black iron pipe. I start by positioning the black iron pipe flanges and drilling holes for screws. I could only find 1-inch long screws, and this being a 3/4-inch top means that the points would poke right through. To fix this issue, I stacked 4 washers between the screw and the flange, lifting it high enough so it won't poke through. With the flanges secured in place, I threaded on the pipes for a test fit. With the pipes in place, I couldn't help but flipping it over and getting a sneak peek at what this will look like. I'll be painting the pipes white, but before I can start, I need to prep the surface. To remove the black coating protecting the pipes, I'll be using acetone. I apply a bit of acetone to a paper towel and I start rubbing away. After a few seconds and a bit of elbow grease, we're left with a nice clean pipe. I repeat this process along the length until the entire pipe is clean. Here are the 3 pipes, all shiny and clean. With the pipes prepped, it's time to start painting. In order to get full coverage, I'm placing them on my makeshift pipe painting stand. Using Krylon Gloss White spray paint, I paint the pipes white. To protect the floor from scratches, I'll be making feet for the pipes with this leftover vinyl flooring material. I start by lining up and tracing the pipe with a black marker. Using scissors, I cut all three circles out. I apply E6000 along the perimeter of the pipe and press on the feet. With the pipes painted and the feet attached, the table legs were done. I then reattached them to the tabletop. With the table flipped right side up, I can sand off any excess wood filler. The edges of the table are still sharp, so I quickly rounded them over using my sander. A router with a round over bit might be more consistent, but this is way more fun. With the edges rounded over and all the surfaces sanded smooth, it's finally time to start painting. To paint everything on the pizza, I'm using regular run-of-the-mill acrylic craft paint. The paint I'm using isn't exactly the best quality, so it takes about 3 coats to cover everything. I also make sure to paint the backside of the dripping cheese, as this can be seen when looking at the table. Don't forget to cover the exposed plywood edges. With the base color of cheese down, it's time to start working on the crust. With the crust complete, the last thing I need to add are the pepperonis. Once the acrylic paint had dried, the last thing I needed to do was give the entire thing a coat of Krylon Clear Acrylic Flat Spray Paint. Once the spray paint dries, this project is done. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Also, check out some of my other videos. That'll do it for this one, and I'll catch you guys next time.